storm show. It's a storm show.
What is up, Storm Chasers? Yesterday, Game Over Skip, or Skip as we know him, he used to be a dancer for Big Freedia, who is the queen of bounce out of New Orleans. He came over to our platform to give an interview about new projects, as well as how he had felt slighted by big hitters in the industry. He addressed Drake, he addressed the Beyonce situation, and he addressed the IG viral sensation Nick Paddywhack and Dan Rue. He actually made claims that their whole shtick was just a funnier version of him and his friend Big Chew down there in New Orleans. And so today you are going to actually watch Nick's response to Skip. What is up, Storm Chasers? Today I have the viral sensation, the IG man. We know him as Nick and Paddywhack. You done seen him literally grow his platform to IG. You've seen him on BET and numerous of other streaming platforms. Shit, what part was the lie? Just how
about bro, it's like, if you're going to tell the truth, you got to tell the whole truth. So I'm going to go ahead and start by saying, yes, we did have conversations and had a meeting because you wanted to do business. Because just like they said, they kept saying, culture vultures, we do this, we do that. Bitch, I'm from here. How am I a culture vulture if I grew up in the culture? You know what I'm saying? Even when we was at Airline Skating Rink, I'd be 15, 16, Skip would be 22, 23, dancing against little kids, everybody doing the same dance. The same dance, but me and Dan blew up doing it. Now it's a problem. But nobody never tell the Double Time Boys, Showtime Boys, Right Side Boys, none of them when they do the Peter Pan. But as soon as me and Dan go and do the Peter Pan and make a joke out of it, it's a problem. But I'm not gonna get off topic.
So that whole Peter Pan dance, Skip is saying that came from Big Chew. You saying that that's more just a New Orleans?
You know what? He can say it came from Big Chew. You know what I'm saying? If you look at the dance, bro, I'm not going to even knock it. If you look at the dance, it looked like it was a touchdown celebration they used to do in the 80s. Everybody got the same dance. Everybody switched up. You got people. Yeah, bro. You got people hitting a whoa. You got people hitting a All that. And it's all the same thing. All it took was somebody just altered a little bit and give it a name. So, okay, cool. I give him credit. You created the Peter Pan. That's what you want. But my thing is, if I was to go on a show every day and keep saying, oh, Skip did this, Big Chew did this, Skip did this, Big Chew did this, then what? You really think these people are going to come follow you because you came up with a dance? No, they don't want to see that. They want it funny. That was the whole thing. They wanted to see the funniness of it. We didn't just go up and be like, yeah, baby, we live, and do a dance and then walk off. Nigga did, yeah, baby, we live, go in the store, steal some shit, make some rhyme, say some funny shit, and then we'll dip. That was the whole plot. He didn't say nothing, he just danced. It was a whole mix. Like, it wasn't just like, I'll walk in there and I make a song and make my homeboy dance and then we walk out. We did something that was funny. You know what I'm saying? Right. Like he said, they've been doing this for years. The same thing for years. And it took two motherfuckers to come make a joke out of it to blow up with it. What's the problem?
I think, because I'm not a part of that particular culture, so I'm new to all of this. But from what I gathered from what he was saying, what Skip was saying was like, well, why were we never included in any of your viral videos or any of your, I guess maybe they wanted to be included in your success at some point or acknowledged.
Tried that. And that's why I'm deciding we'll get off topic, because when we had the meetings, we were talking about, matter of fact, over the phone, we were saying, oh, we want to do, we'll shoot a skit. Let's collab. Let's do this. And me and Dan was like, all right, bro, we can do it. But the more we kept saying we can do it, let's do it, closer we got to it, we just started seeing how greedy they were for the spotlight that we were in. It wasn't more like, oh, let's collaborate. It was more like, let me do this and y'all record it and let me be the limelight. That's where it was heading. Because even when we was talking about doing business with selling We Live shirts, we was gonna collaborate. We was like, all right, Fitball Weeby set us down. Rest in peace to his soul. He set us down because we wasn't gonna talk to him. We thought it was greedy. We wasn't gonna talk to him. He set us down. We had a conversation. He said, they was like, so what's up? What are we gonna do? I said, bro, it's whatever y'all want to do, bro. We're here to knock out business, and we're here to spread the culture, bring y'all in on it so people can stop talking, because the whole city was already talking shit about me and Dan. But me and Dan and Kelly, we just having fun.
And what was the city saying about y'all, though? Like, what was this,
something they would say? Because there was already some shit behind our back. There was like, oh, y'all whack, y'all fake, y'all stealing this, y'all running off with this. How you live and you living a lie. Just basically saying I'm the real Mr. Will, I'm not that other nigga, this, that, and third. But I'm like, bro, you talking so much shit, but you want us to do videos with you. So we already went to the meeting, like, already aggravated, like, all right, what we got to do to just, like, get this over with. They didn't want to do just one video. They wanted to do a video every week. And when we did the shirts, we was like, all right, cool. We give you 10% of every 50 shirts. And they counted back trying to negotiate, saying, no, we want 10% of every shirt that's 50. And I'm just like, nigga, I just said that. Like, that's the same thing. If you know Matt, like I know Matt, whether it's 10% of 50 shirts or 10% of every shirt that's 50, nigga, you're going to get the same fucking money. So why are you sounding so greedy?
Embrace Pangea is a black-owned health and wellness brand that has solidified themselves as being able to take care of your yoni, but guess what? They do more than just service your yoni. Yes, as a matter of fact, Embrace Pangea has products to cover you from head to toe, inside and out. And in particular, let me tell you about a couple products that I personally use. Number one is the herbal tooth powder that is better than any toothpaste that you will get over the counter. It will get your teeth clean and help your teeth to maintain a natural white shade. And in addition to that, the advanced botanical mouthwash is something that we all should have in our medicine cabinet. Now, when you look at a bottle like this with 25 potent herbs like echinacea, golden cell, don't laugh at me if I mispronounced that, you know what I meant. We need these natural ingredients in our mouth rinses so that we can fight tooth decay, gingivitis, all of that plaque, halitosis, and overall poor oral hygiene, okay? So if you want to get a good clearance when you go to the dentist, get you some Embrace Pangea, and in addition to that, make sure you use my code STORM to get 10% off your order and check out today.
We don't mind helping you. We don't mind doing this as a team. But is it really going to be teamwork in the end? Or y'all want the spotlight because y'all been on, you think you can dance, you've been on Fuse TV, you've been all around the world, you've been here, you've been there, and you didn't get as far as you wanted to because you've been doing it for so long. And it just takes two ignorant, funny motherfuckers to come out the blue and do this shit and blow up. Because they was being funny with it. And now you have a problem with it. You have a problem with it so much to where you go on social media every day, so salty, so bitter, and you in the comments, you in everybody comments, saying, oh, I made this dance. Oh, he acting like Big Chew, Well, who the fuck Big Chew acting like? I could have sworn Austin Powers sounded like that. Who else? The fucking Pink Panther sound like that. The fucking bear from Wizard of Oz sound, not the lion from the Oz sound like that. They all sound alike. So therefore, he's inspired by somebody. Digital Underground. He's inspired. Nope, that's not his voice. So where he got it from?
You keep saying we stole this. Everybody gets inspiration from somewhere. And then even and Skip did say, for the people that is watching this interview, Skip did say, okay, well, you know, Dan and Nick, they're just, you know, Nick is literally just a funnier version of my friend. That's very hard to say for fact that somebody copies somebody else because y'all from the same culture. I'm sure you got uncles and aunties that say, yeah, baby. Like, it's just...
Yeah, it's just, bro, it's just that this... And to backtrack on the interview that y'all had, and he was like, nobody want to do nothing with New Orleans people, but they go do this, that, and the third. It's like he said, like, New Orleans don't have each other back. Like, when we was doing it, they wasn't really supportive, bro. They didn't even want us to, like, they didn't even want to join up, bro. They really just wanted to switch positions. And, bro, and, like, in New Orleans, it's like a bucket of crabs, bro. As soon as one person get ready to climb out, you know, the other crabs start to pull you down. Me and Dan wasn't trying to ruin them niggas. Me and Dan, we was having fun. We ain't mind doing videos with them. But Skip was salty. Big Chew was salty. So it was like, fuck it. We wasn't trying to run off with it and beat them. We wasn't getting paid for acting like them. Nobody paid us to act like them.
Right.
We didn't even get paid on Instagram. We had our manager reach out to certain companies that allow us to do certain shit. Cause who wanna book two people that just gonna be like, yeah, we live, baby, and just do a Peter Pan and then run off. Right. We wasn't getting no money for that.
And that's what a lot of people don't understand when it comes to Instagram, like, you make your money if you got a sponsor deal, if you holding a product saying, you know, click the link or whatever. Like, a lot of people that go viral on IG, that doesn't necessarily equate to dollars. So yeah, for a while that was more just you guys building your platform. You wasn't getting a check from IG just because you hit a million views in a video.
Yemaya's Gift is a brand that specializes in medicinal herbs and all natural supplements to help alleviate a lot of conditions that Americans suffer from, okay? Now, Yemaya's Gift got products to help you with that hypertension, to help speed up that weight loss, get rid of them fibroids, as well as help alleviate the symptoms of that diabetes. Oh yeah, that sugar is real bad. So now with Yemaya's Gift, you get a lot of gifts, but the best gift that anyone could ever give you is the ability to heal thyself from the inside out with products like elderberry syrup to help keep that immunity in check, because we all fighting Miss Rona. We all trying to windmill her ass up out of our lives. But one of my personal favorites, as a matter of fact, two of my personal favorite products with Yemaya's Gift is the all natural honey and the tea that's for men. And the reason why I like those products is because if you are somebody with a low sex drive, you need a boost in the bedroom, and if you are ready to get Brian Pumped, Lexington Steeled all night long, then just put some of that in your man's cup and you will be on your way to a happier, healthy marriage. All right, now place your orders today. Whether you need your immunity taken care of, you're trying to lose some weight, you're trying to get rid of that sugar, the diabetes, or you're just trying to bust a nut, okay, order her shit at www.yemayasgift.com.
Yeah, and Instagram don't pay people directly. You got to go out there and get it. So yeah. That's another thing, bro. Like, he was like, oh, y'all making all this money, y'all making millions. Bro, I stay in a lot of downtown, bro, in Los Angeles. I went out on a whim and just left the city because ain't shit here. He's been here doing the same thing for years. When after you think you could dance, you was gonna leave New Orleans and go out there and spread the culture. You staying in New Orleans doing the same shit you've been in New Orleans. You think that's spreading the culture? Or because you go dance in the city every other week, or you go take a booking here, you go do that. Bro, you got to actually get out there and go travel the world, and other than just week by week by week. You got to stay in certain places and go to certain events and be a part of events and collaborate with other dancers and spread that culture to them. That's what Dan do. Dan is not from New Orleans. Dan was on the outskirts in Baton Rouge, but that nigga made sure he came down here in New Orleans. I hooked him up with Right Side Ronnie, and okay, we taught him how to dance. Dan couldn't
even taught Dan that dance. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, bro, matter of fact, Dan didn't even learn to dance from Right Side Ronnie or Skip. Dan is 31 years old. Dan went to Southern University with Sonic. Sonic is in Game Over with Skip. So guess how long Sonic been at Southern University? Since 2005.
Wow.
He been spreading the culture at Southern. He one of the main people that got bounce really popping out there in Baton Rouge. So guess who Dan was watching as he was on campus when he was coming up? Sonic.
Gotcha.
And when all this shit popped off, you know who Dan walked up to and shook his hand and said, bro, I'm sorry for all this shit that's going on, but you was my main inspiration on why I learned how to do the dance, why I want to be more into bounce dancing. Sonic can tell you. Sonic, if you get Sonic and call him and find him somewhere, he would tell you how Dan felt sorry about everything that was going on. And he apologized to Sonic because he didn't give Sonic credit when it happened. But we felt like if it's New Orleans and everybody in the culture, we all doing the dance and nobody's saying, like, you stole my dance move, you stole my dance move, you stole my dance move. We felt like it was all love.
Okay. And that's part of the reason, like you just said, why you guys eventually moved out of New Orleans, because you feel like, well, damn, if I'm growing, it's gonna be a problem. It's gonna be a problem. But it seems like everybody that becomes a star that is from New Orleans, it's like they have to leave anyway. It's like you really, I don't know anyone.
Yeah. It's the same thing in any state, bro. Whether it's Philadelphia, sure, or New York, your city will build you up, bro. And then once they build you up, they don't mind tearing you down. They'll find any reason. Anybody in the world can find a reason to build you up and tear you down. It's just, bro, just some people just, they have that animosity like that, and that could be me. I wish I would have thought it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, we were just having fun with it, bro. Nobody thought it would pick up, whether it was Chris Brown or T-Pain or Worldstar, bro. We didn't care, because me and Dan was already doing videos before that. I was big on Vine before I got big on Instagram. Niggas will tell you, I'm a pioneer for social media. He could be a pioneer for fucking dancing all he want, but I knew how to market myself and get out there to the world and spread culture, not just in the city, but through an app to where people are like, oh, damn, I got to go to New Orleans. I got to go try that. We got to go do that. That's why some people just, they want to be around Super, Tokyo, Tourism Act That Fee, because these motherfuckers are spreading the culture, not just where they at, but through an app.
Yeah.
And they're actually going to these places and being a part of these places and collaborating with people that's in that city, showing them how we do this and how we do that and what we talk about and what we eat. Getting on this app, just you know, venting and saying, oh, I made this. All right, cool, you made it, but you're not out here showing motherfuckers how to do it. You're not going state to state and spreading the culture. You staying at home just being salty. I'm not gonna even knock him and say he's not putting in work. What I'm saying is if you've been doing something for so long and it's not really working for you, then it's like, all right, cool, now I gotta try something else. I started off with Super, Tokyo, and all them, and then everybody started escalating past me. I'm like, well, damn, nigga, everybody got more followers. What's next? All right, I found a new niche. That was what's next. I stopped doing videos with Dan for a year and a few months, bro, and niggas were still saying, oh, y'all still stealing our shit. Y'all running off with our shit. I took a break from Dan, bro, just because I wanted to know what was next for me other than just social media. I got several businesses, bro, that I don't even put my face on, because if I did, I know niggas would hate
me. For everybody that is trying to make you big on social media, the whole purpose of this is literally a free marketing app. You're supposed to use this to build other businesses, to build other ventures. Like, you don't supposed to get on, unless even YouTube. You don't supposed to get on YouTube just to want to stay on YouTube forever, because what you going to do if YouTube shut down?
Yeah.
But what you going to do? Your whole identity is gone. And so, yes, you build and you grow. And some people in life are better at making moves than others. That's just a fact. Some people can invent themselves quicker. Nobody owes you anything in life.
Facts.
Like nobody, like even like when you look at white folks and how they do business, they don't, there's not an expectation of you have to pull somebody up just because you made it and they didn't.
Right.
So that is something within just black people, period, that we have to kind of get out of that. You can't feel guilty for somebody that's not in your position. It's just, it may not be the season, or it may not be meant for them to do what you're doing.
All right, when a nigga telling that all the time, bro. We didn't swatch this. We swatch this shit every year, bro. So when I saw him do this interview, I'm just like, bro, I'm gonna give you what you want. I'm like, my mindset is I want everybody to be famous and rich, because if we all was rich and famous, bro, do you think we'd be worried about the next motherfucker?
No,
exactly.
You wouldn't have time.
Yeah, you'll be worried about yourself. So I'm like, I wish you had my followers just as much as I did, because by you looking up, you feel like I'm above you. But bro, if we both human beings, you probably got way more money than me. I just got way more followers, bro. And you taking it the wrong way, because we do this every year. Every year this dance come up. Whether it's in a Super Bowl commercial, whether it's on a dance show or whatever, it's always, oh no, they stole it from me, they did that. Even if we're not even on the page looking at it, he the first one in the comments. It's aggravating. It's aggravating, bro. Okay. And no matter how many times we can shout this nigga out every day, it won't make no difference. He's bitter for no reason. I don't want to make this whole interview about me just, you know, downplaying him and saying he bit his snout a third. But it's aggravating, bro. It's been going on since 2017. We didn't come to a conclusion yet. So what do you really want?
That is true. And what I gather from it is that he wanted acknowledgement, but you're telling me you guys have already given him that. So it ain't nothing else.
Bro, go, when you get done with this interview, bro, go on YouTube and type in Big Chew versus Nick and Dan. Scroll down about the fifth video. It starts off disrespectful. And you can look at it and you can see it. It's like, I think it's like probably 8 minutes, 2 minutes or less. And the contradiction is, y'all ain't give us no recognition. Y'all ain't, you shout us out. Y'all ain't say we did this, that, and says do that. I'm like, bro, you're contradicting yourself through the whole video. You posting receipts that showing what we did, how we did it.
The real Mr. V Live speaks out. Okay, so this shit goes all the way back. Damn.
It's tiring, bro. It's tiring. So imagine somebody like actually trying to like, you know, collaborate, do something with you. And your whole intention is just to like be greedy from the get-go because you want this situation to be you so bad.
Are you struggling with hair growth issues? Or are you ready to finally be able to actually put your hair in a real ponytail and not that little knob? Have you found that beauty supply products leave your hair dry, flat, useless, and dull? And are you ready for a change? And if you are, you need to try some Moo Moo Grease. Moo. This product was created for us, and nothing will change about your hair if you don't change your regimen. This product can be used in old people, young people, it doesn't matter. The products are 100% vegan, and all of the information for Moo Grease is down in the description box below.
Bro, and the New Orleans culture, bro, is like, it's not even stealing, bro. Because when you listen to a bounce song, bro, and you hear the samples in the background, do you think any of these bounce artists get that clearance?
Most of the time, no.
bro, these bounce hard. Keep it moving. Right, and it's because it sounds good. That's our culture. We'll take some and we put it in with ours, mixed up, and it blends so well. You know what I'm saying? Nobody about to go out there and try to get clearance. That's why Kirk Franklin was jealous, because High Sizzle did a live version of "Rain Down on Me," and he was just like, "I didn't clear any other version. This is the only version." Da da da. Because I should sound better. Nobody got time to sit there and go get clearance. You know what I'm saying? They can just do that shit and have fun with it.
Right.
They just have fun with it. And other motherfuckers, I guess, when they see something is better than theirs, they feel some type of way.
Let me ask you something too, Nick. Did in all the meetings, any talks you had with Skip and Big Chew, did they ever ask you how you navigated the platform of Instagram to go viral? Because there is a method to it.
They already knew. It was being funny. Like anything on social media that's funny, people gravitate towards it, bro. And then even if it's not, it was like at one point it was like doing 60-second skits. When you write something down and you draw it out, and you have multiple angles and they have a punchline in it. But then it got boring. So then it started coming out with raw content, 60 seconds all the way through. You run up on somebody, you do some fun shit, everybody think it's real. The market switch up, bro. The demographics switch up. Everybody wants to see something different every time, which is why on TikTok now, you can copy somebody and do the same thing, but switch it up, and yours can go way more viral. It's just everything is different. On Vine, it was 6 seconds. You had to be so creative in 6 seconds, and people were like, the punchline was so fast. I missed it. I got to watch it again. And right. It's just different. On Twitter, you got to have some type of some ignorant black comedy for the video to go either viral, or you got to showcase some ignorant stuff that's happening for people to be like, oh yeah, we got to make this go viral.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to get people attention. You're doing the same dance over and over and over, you know, and the same ad-libs over and over and over without being funny or at least having fun with it. Cause this is your job. Now at this point, you do it every day. You wake up every day and you do it. This is your job. Whenever you start treating something like a job, bro, it's no longer fun. It's no longer fun. You have fun with these interviews, bro. You have fun with these interviews.
I do. Exactly.
Because I know when I DM'd you, it was like, oh, shit, it's getting spicy now. I'm already knowing.
I ain't going to lie, bro. I didn't even think y'all would ever see it because I'm like, your platform is so big. I'm like, but damn, who sent him this? But hey, it's when you talk about New Orleans, it's like, look. If you talk about somebody, they do have a right to respond. That's only fair. That's only fair because I don't have a hat in this match.
Right. You're just a mediator. I only saw it because Dan said it to me. So his whole thing is he really want to work with Dan more than he want to work with me because he feel like I'm the pioneer of steering Dan away and making them not want to work together. which is false. I have nothing to do with that. I said, Dan, if you want to dance with that nigga, you can go dance with him. You a dancer. Me, I'm a comedian. I'm a club host. I'm an EDM DJ. And I don't want to act. I don't want to be on social media all day doing the same shit over and over.
Are you living a hectic and stressful life? Between the news and racial stress and trauma, do you find yourself feeling alone and anxious? If so, join our community, Mind, Body, Faith, and learn how to establish daily practices that aid in healing the mind, body, and spirit, like meditation, yoga, prayer, breath work, and journaling. Pause and let your spirit breathe by using our meditation prayer cards and meditation candles when you need to reconnect with God. Start on your new path by taking our meditation quiz, because it's always a good time to meditate with God.
It's tiring, you know what I'm saying? So I told him he can do that. Danny won't do it because Dan see how greedy he is. Skip is an opportunist. Skip is an opportunist. From the interview that was going on, bro, everything you heard, bro, it just sounded like he was bidding. He didn't get to be a part of everything that he saw. Me and Dan was salty. We wasn't in Drake video, but we didn't care. We was like, all right, cool. We'll get the next one. You know what I'm saying? It was like, I was like, bro, I don't even care to be in that video, bro. That's all Shiggy. Shiggy deserved that because he blew that song up. Why would he put two other social media influencers in there when Shiggy made that song pop? Because that song wasn't originally going to be, it wasn't going to have a video for it until Shiggy shot did a little dance for it and blew it up. And then that's when it was like, now we got to do this. And then Nice for What video, the Nice for What, he wanted that for females. Like, you know, that's how he marketed himself. He wanted to cater to the females more than that. Nobody want a nigga in the background moving their legs all day. Like, niggas shoot music videos for females. When have you ever seen a nigga shoot a music video and it just be for niggas dancing?
Nah, that's a good
point. If it's a dance video, then cool. But when have we ever shot a song that correlates for females, a nigga in the background dancing?
That's a good point. And even if you do got the niggas that's dancing, they're clearly dancing for the women that's watching. That's a good point.
Right. And to attack the fact that when I made a song saying the Peter Pan and shit like that, I was only like trying to like expand on me and Dan's, you know, popularity at the time. The song went double platinum, but it didn't get cleared. I didn't put 3 samples in the song, so couldn't get no fucking plaques for that. You know what I'm saying?
Let me ask you this, Nick. Do you feel any kind of way when you see celebrities and people with big platforms that are clearly influenced by New Orleans culture, things you say, do you feel any kind of way with that?
I feel the same way Skip feel. I feel like if you're going to do something New Orleans, at least have somebody from New Orleans to help you out with it or be a part of it. You know what I'm saying? If they was inspired by what you did, then yeah, I feel like they should, you know, give you recognition. You know what I'm saying? They should definitely do that. My only thing is, don't be sad and bitter when they don't pick you, because you feel like it should be you and you're one of the main pioneers in New Orleans.
Yeah,
you feel me? They can pick anybody they want. They can pick somebody that, like, Megan could have found somebody that she grew up with that moved from Louisiana during Hurricane Katrina, and then she just grew up in Texas the rest of her life. But she was one with the culture and know everything about New Orleans and know how to do New Orleans because there was a part of that. Right. I just feel like you shouldn't be mad who they choose to help them with their choreography or who helped them pick this and that. If they're from New Orleans, then cool. If they're not, then yeah, you could be mad. Then that's a culture vulture. But we don't know who they got that choreography from. The dude Jacque, whatever his name is, who he had come on set to do this, that, and the third. We don't know what happened. We don't know what's going on. Niggas ain't out the blue gonna just come out the blue and just start doing shit like this. Somebody from New Orleans either probably showed him and taught him, or if they did steal it, then yeah, he do deserve recognition. But not just him. That whole dance has been going on for a while. Yeah, if somebody did steal it, he would have been said something. Way back when they was battling in Airline Skating Ring. You can look at that too on YouTube. You can type in New Orleans Airline Skating Ring Bounce. You're gonna see a lot of videos, everybody doing the same thing.
You know what I wonder too for people that are creatives on social media, is there any way that you can protect either, well, of course you can like copyright your scenes and stuff, but when it comes to dance moves, there's no way to legally protect a dance move, right?
It's really not, bro. That's why the dude who did the Billy Bounce.
Yes.
I think he was trying to copyright his dance too, because people kept mixing the Peter Pan up with his shit. And people were saying you can't really copyright a dance, because Dan tried to go get it copyrighted for 2K, because 2K didn't want no problems when they saw this shit going on.
Right.
And it was like, you can't copyright a dance. Because like I said, bro, people been doing all these type of gestures and movements since the 50s. And all it takes is somebody to come from the 60s and look at it and switch it up. Somebody from the 70s, then the 80s. And it's just the evolution, bro, evolution. Like he told you, bro, bounce in the 80s and 90s, it was different. Girls wasn't twerking how they twerk now. You know what I'm saying? Back then, they'll just move their booty like this, and it's just like that. Now these motherfuckers is swiggling, throwing their ass everywhere. It's different. It's no longer twerking. It's shaking. They call it shaking. That's what makes them different from Texas. Texas, they twerk, and New Orleans, they shake.
Okay. And speaking of evolution, too, I just had somebody DM me something. It was a dance from either Kenya, one of those countries on the eastern side of Africa, where they were doing that too. Because if you think about it, black folks really been dancing, right, even in slavery. Like, we all passed that shit down from generation to generation. So.
Right. And who was to say who created what? Because you just put a name on it and a timestamp. You know what I'm saying? That swiggling shit, like you said, the swiggling was for the punks and the females. Why haven't the creator of the swiggle come forward and be like, this nigga's stealing my dance? Bro, because the thing is, bro, if he feel like we culture vultures, bro, that's how he feel. Everybody else that support us, they're like, y'all niggas spreading the culture. That's why people support Big Frida, Sisanobi, Flyboy Keno. Flyboy Keno don't even get the love that he deserves. This motherfucker does bounce, and he took that bounce shit and went straight to EDM with it. Now all the white people wanted more. That's why Diplo did something with Nicki to be. They spreading that shit, bro. And they're not just spreading it towards the black culture. They're trying to spread it to the white motherfuckers too.
And I think even in this industry, man, you just gotta find like where you fit. Cause like maybe what you're doing ain't working where you at, but you could take that shit to maybe Japan and they would love it. And you could have a whole overseas. So it's like you gotta find where you fit, man.
They do love it in Japan. We flew out there twice.
Ladies, treat Gianni.
All natural herbs for a fresher, tighter, cleaner, healthier Yanni.
This is the Yanni bowl. Here are the herbs, the natural herbs.
You know, a little steamy down there, but you know, it perks to it. Keep things, everything right and tight.
I'm going to Yanni steam. If you haven't heard about it, definitely gotta research it. It has wonderful, wonderful benefits.
So ladies, try her out.
We went to Okinawa. They love that shit, bro. They like when we do shit like that. They knew the music before we even got there. I told them play a bounce song. They wanted to hear songs from Big Frida. And a few songs from DJ Jubilee. They already knew what the fuck was going on when a nigga walked in there and backed that ass up. That's all they know. And she rolled that dick like a soldier. They motherfuckers on the floor just doing everything. They humping each other because they're trying to shake their ass. They don't know what the fuck to do.
And a lot of people don't understand that too. Even American artists, man, they'll go overseas. They're like, okay, I ain't really getting the recognition here. Go over. And people love it. So it's just about having an open mind. But I will say this for anybody, if you're not, and I haven't talked to Skip about this, but if you're not willing to leave your comfort zone, or if you're not willing to leave where you're from, then that will inhibit your growth. Because being mainstream, you really need to be like in LA, right? LA, New York, pretty much.
Yeah, I mean, at least LA, Atlanta. And we're not just talking about going there for a weekend and going to a party, but we're actually talking about like being within their culture and actually networking with they're pioneers and doing shit with them over and over and over and building your platform in a whole nother state. Bro, I left New Orleans, I want to say 8 years ago. I moved to Baton Rouge. I had to build a whole new following in Baton Rouge. Then after Baton Rouge, bro, nigga was like, all right, cool, what's next? Nigga, I had to go to L.A. Got to L.A. Me and Dan moved to L.A. on a whim. When we had to sell a house with five niggas, me and my homie, me and my brother, we had to sell a bed head to toe. Dan had a small-ass room. My other two partners, they had small-ass room. We was in a townhouse. We was paying $4,000 a month. We went out on a whim, and we just was like, let's make the best of it. Now everybody doing something different. My homie, he doing moves with Tom Cruise right now in Europe. My other homie, he's a rapper. Dan is doing him. I'm over here doing, I just did two movies in the commercial, and now I'm doing EDM as a DJ. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not forever. You got to do something different. You got to move out of what you know and pick something up and then dominate that.
You're right.
You got to be different. This nigga, if you're going to dance all day, bro, cool. Learn a new dance. Go to New York and learn how to crump. Go learn how to couture. Go learn how to do all this shit that people are reaching out for them to be a part of. Learn how to do what they do and conquer their shit. Don't just do one thing for the rest of your life, bro. You say you're 33. I've been watching you since I was 16. I've been to the same spots you've been at since I was 16. We've been in the same spots everywhere, whether they speak or not. Niggas know who I was. When I hit 18, niggas knew who I was because I was throwing parties. You know what I'm saying? I'm throwing parties, hosting parties. Niggas knew who I was at the age of 18. I was popping before I even was popping. Now that nigga more popping on a larger scale, now it's like, damn, I was in the same party with this nigga, the same scaring with this nigga, and here he go, gonna jump past me with fame and followers. Nah, I don't like that. Nigga, you gotta do something different.
You do. And it sounds like even what maybe he or anybody in that situation could benefit from is just like some guidance, somebody to say, okay, well, you got that going now, like a manager or something to say, okay, now we're gonna kind of transition into this, like, It's reasons why people build a team as they grow, because you can't stay on top of everything. So I think, I have empathy for how a person could feel to see, okay, we was in the same spot. They're here now and I'm here. Anybody can make it happen for themselves. Like, you don't need anybody. You just need to do it. Like,
and it's the same thing with rappers wanting to do movies, bro. Like, you always got to, like, what's that word I'm looking for? Revamp or you got to restart yourself to find, really? Like,
you do.
Yeah. Yeah. And, like, you know, like, even when it was on, it was traveling, it was part of the shit with Big Freedia and all that. I feel like he didn't branch on like he should have. You know what I'm saying? Like, what's that word I'm looking for? Capitalize. He didn't capitalize. Once, when all that shit was going on, I felt like you should have got a manager. You should have had a manager reaching out to certain people. I feel like even if Big Freedia did go to jail, that should never stop you from getting your bag, travel, go be here, go be there. I feel like you should have had like your own team helping you put videos out and send off like pilots and shit. Cause you're already on Fuse TV. You're already working with Viacom. You know what I'm saying? All you got to do is just reach out because you're already an employee. You're working with them already. You didn't capitalize. And that, I said that all the time with me and Dan. Me and Dan missed out on millions, missed out on YouTube money, missed out on doing certain stuff because we felt like, nah, we're too good for that. We didn't capitalize. So I'm not ashamed to say, you know, when I'm wrong, you know what I'm saying? Or when I didn't do something, I should have did it. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying is, I know I should have done it. I'm saying he should have did the same thing. He didn't capitalize. True. There's no way you should not be. You've been on TV three, four times and a TV show. Different shows.
Because you know what, brother? You know what I would have loved to see? A spinoff with Skip and Flash. Like, I would have loved to have seen the show with them trying to do their thing. So it's, you're right, man. And that's why you got to.
It could have been a spinoff with Skip and Flash traveling the world trying to find traveling New Orleans trying to find a better bounce artist to work with. It could have been Kino, it could have been Nobi, it could have been Hot Sizzle, it could have been like, damn, all these good ass artists, we don't know who we want to work with.
Right.
It could have been a dope ass pod. It would have been something, you know, it don't even matter what it would have been. Long as they would have been on the TV, the whole city of New Orleans would have still supported them. Even if they didn't watch, they would have found an episode on YouTube and watch that shit.
True that.
That's the only I watched the show to see what Frida and all of them was gonna be doing because I didn't know what kind of show Frida was having. I just saw the commercial. I just saw Frida walking down the hall with bounce music. I'm like, oh, I wonder what this shit gonna be. I watched one episode. Like, oh yeah, this is actually fire.
And you know what too? Like even when you know that show and stuff came out, like it introduced the world to a whole culture. We had no idea. Like we didn't. We like what? That's how they get down in New Orleans. Like this shit is live. I used to watch that and be like, damn, I wish I was from New Orleans because it's just so much culture and so
it is no lie, it is definitely it's so much fun to be down here, bro. It's real lit. When I go to other states, I be like, damn, y'all don't got no bounce music, man. I gotta get drunk to hear this shit. Like I don't want to hear this shit, man. This shit whack. But it's just that's just me missing the city because that music gets you hyped. It gets you lit. It brings all the females' booty, butt cheeks out. You get to see ass. You know what I'm saying? It's different.
Well, brother, I mean, I thank you for coming by. Unless there's anything else you wanted to address from that interview, do you feel like you have both sides?
I feel like all I'm saying is I feel like Skip should let that hurt go because it's going to really just keep him stuck forever. Big 2 let it go. He need to let it go because you don't see Big 2 in the comments. That's the only reason I came in today, bro. I just wanted to say, let it go. Because he was just in my DMs 2 days ago. He was fussing. And I didn't think he was going to do this interview. So
wait, that's what made me mad. He was in your DM 2 days ago?
Yeah, because he wrote something when they was doing the little challenge. Dan had wrote on, it's the Peter Pan and the Swiggle for me. And then it just blew up on the shade room. And then he go in the comments, doing this, doing that, doing that. And I told him, I was like, bro, let it go, bro. You're doing the most. Then he tagged me in a story. I replied. And then he wrote another paragraph. And then I started trolling him. I told him, I said, bro, I'll blow you up overnight. Come sign to like We Live Baby Entertainment. You're just doing the most. But I took the Suge Knight approach. I was like, you over there dancing. You're not blowing up. You want to get some TV time. Come sign to We Live Baby Entertainment. You know, just trolling. Because at this point, that's all it is. It's like, it's a joke. It's tiring.
Well, I tell you what, man, you've taken time out of your day to come on my platform, which I do appreciate. Do you want to shout out any projects you're doing? Tell the people where they can find you. Like, I want this to be
worth it. Nah, they ain't got to find me, bro. I strictly did this just for Skip because I know Skip won't see it. I want Skip to just see this interview, sit down and watch it, and come to realization. Like, I need to let that hurt go.
It's Storm Show. It's a storm show.